It was a dizzying day for NASA. First, NASA executives announced that the space agency will open up parts of the International Space Station to more commercial opportunities, including hosting private astronauts, allowing companies unprecedented use of the space station's facilities, including filming commercials or movies against the backdrop of space. The plans not only involve making room on the station for commercial services, but also reserves a docking berth for a privately owned and operated habitat module. This newsflash, representing a major change in policy for NASA, was soon overshadowed by a tweet from President Trump that called into question his own administration's much-publicized goal of returning astronauts to the moon by 2024. "For all the money we're spending, NASA should not be talking about going to the moon. We did that 50 years ago," Trump said on Twitter. "We should be focused on the much bigger things we're doing, including Mars, of which the moon is a part, defense and science." It's unclear if Trump was unhappy with the current NASA plan or was expressing exasperation at the pace of human exploration of deep space. Trump's confusing language about the moon being a part of Mars plausibly referred to NASA's framing of the moon plan as part of a longer-term goal of exploring Mars. Trump's confusing tweet came just hours after NASA's administrator, Jim Bridenstine, warned that the biggest challenge to the moon plan was not technological but rather the political risk. Speaking at the International Space Development Conference in Arlington, Bridenstine said, "How do we retire the political risk? We go faster. We accelerate the program. The longer it drags out, the more risk there is we're going to get diverted into something else." A White House official said late Friday that the administration's goal has always been to get to Mars, and that the Moon 2024 plan would enable the United States to reach Mars roughly a decade after creating a sustainable presence on the lunar surface. The big news of the day was supposed to be the new commercial opportunities at NASA. The announcement came as the agency's trying to return humans to the moon by 2024, a mission that officials said would require significant additional funding. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss NASA's plan to open the International Space Station to tourists, why NASA wants to commercialize the International Space Station. Let's get into details. NASA's announcement is a significant change for the agency, which has long been antagonistic towards commercializing the ISS. Russia is more open to ads and branding on the ISS and has sent tourists to the ISS before. Russia has allowed several private astronauts on the station, but NASA has strictly prohibited the use of its side of the International Space Station for commercial purposes. Richard Garriott, an entrepreneur whose father was a NASA astronaut, traveled to the space station as a private astronaut in 2008 on a Russian rocket. At the time, NASA was so opposed to his trip that it tried to prohibit him from entering the U.S. segment of the space station. "I was basically banned," he said in a recent interview. Ultimately, though, it was up to the commander of the space station to make that call, and so he was allowed after all. Up until now, any company wishing to send products to the ISS had to show that there was some educational component to the undertaking, or that it revolved around some kind of technology demonstration. No purely commercial projects are allowed to be sent to the ISS, and NASA astronauts are even prohibited from working on experiments if there's a possibility that the research will be used to make a profit. The move is part of a broader push by the Trump administration to end government funding for the ISS and allow commercial enterprise to fund what is now astronauts' home in space. NASA leadership has made it clear that the space agency wants to eventually transition control of the International Space Station and its region of space, low Earth orbit, into the private sector someday. It costs NASA $3 to $4 billion a year to operate the ISS, and by handing over control of the station, NASA could have more money to pursue much more ambitious missions, like the agency's goals of building a new space station around the moon and sending humans back to the lunar surface. NASA is looking to jumpstart the private space industry's takeover of low Earth orbit. To achieve this, NASA commissioned 12 companies to study ways of establishing a heavy commercial presence in this region of space. Each company detailed ideas for new private space habitats that could either be attached to the ISS or fly free in low Earth orbit. Such platforms could serve as destinations for research and even private visitors, according to NASA, generating revenue and opening up entirely new business models. NASA did admit that the barrier to entry is still high, since transporting people and cargo to space is quite expensive. But the space agency is still moving forward with commercialization based on what these studies found. Using the space station will come with new restrictions. The initial offering is to sell to each bidder 5% of NASA's annual allocation of crew resources and station cargo capacity, as well as 90 hours of crew time and 175 kilograms, that's 365 pounds, of payload space aboard a cargo shipment to the space station. The reason for this tight share offering is to encourage competition among customers. In addition, this new directive will allow private astronauts to spend up to 30 days in low Earth orbit aboard the ISS to carry out approved commercial activities. With the first mission possible by 2020, the station will accept up to 2 visits per year with the astronauts flying aboard U.S. manned spacecraft. NASA said it believes it can accommodate up to 2 privately funded, short-duration missions a year with essentially space tourists. The new interim directive from NASA allows private companies to buy time and space on the ISS for producing, marketing, or testing their products. It also allows those companies to use resources on the ISS for commercial purposes, even making use of NASA astronauts' time and expertise. If companies want, they can even send their own astronauts to the ISS starting as early as 2020. But all these activities come with a hefty price tag. Seats on flights to the ISS will likely be incredibly expensive, available mostly to the super rich. Jeff DeWitt, NASA's chief financial officer, estimated the cost per trip would be about $50 million a seat, but the cost and arrangements would be left to SpaceX and Boeing. Right now, the only viable option for crew getting to the ISS is via new spacecraft being developed by SpaceX and Boeing for NASA's commercial crew program, which still haven't flown people yet. Neither SpaceX Dragon nor Boeing Starliner are ready. Their transport capsules are supposed to be ready in late 2019, but the timetable depends on the results of a series of tests. So the private missions will have to wait until 2020 at the earliest. They would like to keep that money and also make sure that private astronauts meet NASA's medical standards and the training and certification procedures for crew members. While on board the station, NASA would charge people for food, storage, and communication. Using the space station's facilities will be incredibly expensive. Private astronauts will have to reimburse the government for the cost to the space station, including $11,250 per astronaut per day to use the life support systems and toilet, and $22,500 per day for all necessary crew supplies, like food, air, medical supplies, and more. Even power will cost $42 per kilowatt hour. Ultimately, one night's stay would be about $35,000 for one person, according to Jeff DeWitt, NASA's chief financial officer. But it won't come with any Hilton or Marriott points, DeWitt joked at that day's announcement. Some companies might want to go even bigger and send their own module up to the International Space Station. If they do, NASA has made sure that they'll have an available docking port. NASA is making the port on the station's Harmony module available for a commercial habitat to attach to for a finite period of time. Habitats that dock to this port will have access to the station's utilities, and astronauts could potentially use the module during their stay in space. NASA will soon ask for proposals of habitats that can be attached to Harmony and will make final selections by the end of the fiscal year, according to the NASA Space Agency. NASA made an announcement at the NASDAQ market site with representatives of more than a dozen commercial aerospace companies in attendance, and some are already taking NASA up on its new policy. Space habitat developer Bigelow Aerospace, for instance, says it's already booked 4 private flights of SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft and will send up to 4 of its own private astronauts on each mission once the vehicle finally starts carrying people. And it's possible that even more opportunities for commercial activities are on their way. Right now, commercial activity on the station is largely limited to science experiments. We have no idea what kinds of creativity and literally out-of-the-world ideas can come from private industry, Bill Gerstenmaier, NASA's head of human exploration, said during a news conference. NASA executives made it clear that these new policy changes are just the beginning, and that they're eager to get feedback from the industry. This is the beginning of us actively starting open dialogue with the industry to figure out how we can open up space to commercial activities, where revenue can be generated from private sector companies, said Bill Gerstenmaier. According to NASA, the goal of all this is to make better use of the ISS and also produce more destinations for manned spaceflights in LEO. NASA is seeking concepts for its in-space manufacturing, regenerative medicine, bioengineering, and other fields that could lead to an ongoing, financially viable commercial activities in space that produce a sustainable Earthside demand. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.